I may need help, quite frankly, from attempting to endure the hardship from these ingrate, infidel kids of ours. That's what I need. I may need help from them. If I need help, I need help from them, and that's it. Because you know what? I feel as though a lot like Cain. I do. I feel a lot like Cain because at one time, all these people befriended Cain. They were behind Cain, yet every single one of them turned their backs on Cain. And I know how that feels now because of you. You've made it so my family, they've all turned their backs on me because of you.
Wait just a minute.
You know what, Dad? You and Cain are a lot alike. Because deep down in those sick, twisted minds of yours, you're both nothing but monsters. And this may be inappropriate for a son to say to a father, but as far as I'm concerned, the two of you can rot in hell.
Oh my God. Whoa.
Hold on a second. You don't come down here and talk like that to this man. You understand me? This man is a genius and a billionaire, and he commands respect, and he deserves respect. And Mr. McMahon, I can tell you, I respect you more than anything. And on top of that, Shane O'Mac, the highlight reel is for invited guests only, and I never invited you. You spoiled brat, sanctimonious son of a bitch.
Calling Linda there.
Besides that, this man is your father, asshole. Wow.
No, Chris. That asshole happens to be my father.
This is getting heavy.
Oh, wait a minute. Whoa.
Uh-oh.
Father and son. Let's go. Oh, look at the cheap shot. Jericho with a cheap shot on Shane McMahon. Shane McMahon was face to face with his own father, and Jericho with a cheap shot.
Look at this now.
Knocked Shane McMahon off balance there. That could be the deciding factor in this match. A superplex. Superplex. Oh, my God. Oh, what impact. What a... This is not a diversion. This is the monster himself. It's Cain. That hideous freak, Cain. The man in Tombstone, RVD on the steel steps at SummerSlam. The man that Tombstone, Linda McMahon, a month ago in Los Angeles.
Look at Y2J. He got the hell out of Dodge, didn't he?
This is not good for Shane O'Mac.
Cain coming to dismantle Shane
O'Mac.
God, choke slam. A huge choke slam by that big red monster who has absolutely no conscience whatsoever.
Is that it? Is that all he's going to do?
Where the hell is Cain going?
I don't get it.
Has Cain done all the damage he wants for this night?
You know he hadn't finished the job. I don't get it. But you know what? It's no sense even trying to figure this monster out.
Look at him.
What's Cain doing now? He's stopping.
Nobody. I don't think even Cain knows what's going through his sick mind.
Shane's trying to get up, and Shane's locked eyes with Cain. Shane McMahon sees Cain.
Wait a minute, Shane. You still got a match
don't
here.
Don't do it, Shane. Don't go after him.
Stay
away from
Once
that
again,
man.
JR, it's more guts than brains.
Shane, stay away from Cain.
Let him go.
Shane McMahon is showing no fear and is going after Cain.
What is Shane?
What the hell is Shane? You just somebody get back there and stop Shane.
Well, maybe somebody should stop Cain. I don't know. Don't watch it. This could be a setup, Shane. Don't go through those doors.
Cain went through that door. Where's Cain?
Oh,
Is he outside now or what?
Daylight here in Phoenix or Tucson, and Shane looking for Kane.
Yeah, right. You got to be careful. He could be anywhere.
Assaulting Shane McMahon.
I knew Shane should have never gone out there. We need to get security into the bag. They're in the parking lot or somewhere behind this arena.
They're outside the arena here in Tucson. Oh, God. What? Good God, oh my.
We need security out there.
What the hell is... Kane is just beating the hell out of Shane McMahon.
Look out.
My God, they're... Oh, This is going to get ugly. This is nasty. Right against a concrete wall. He's going to break this kid's back as Kane.
That's what he's got on his sick mind. That's what he wants to
Kane,
do.
Oh, my Kane, God. Kane has set Shane up. This is nothing more than a damn setup. Oh, my God. Oh, no.
What is this?
Tell me that's not what.
Got here.
God, Kane.
I'm telling you, somebody has got to get security back. What is he doing?
Oh, no.
What is that, a dumpster?
Kane is pouring that gasoline in that dumpster. Raw gasoline in that dumpster.
For what?
Oh, no.
Oh, what do you say, Shane? What the hell, huh?
Shane McMahon is helpless. Monster is doing. God. Shane cannot defend himself, and Kane has poured that gasoline in a dumpster.
What for? Don't do that. What? Don't do that.
Oh, no. No, please.
Don't do that. Oh, my God.
Oh, no. Oh, for God's sakes. For the love of God, tell me this
no,
is not going to happen.
No, he can't do that.
This
he
cannot
will not
happen.
Do that.
Will someone please get out? Will someone please help Shane?
Feel my pain!
Someone please help this kid.
We got him!
Security!
No, please, no. Security!
Son of a bitch.
Shane. You know, I think I speak for millions of fans when I say that the images we saw last week going off the air were nothing short of disturbing. Kane attempting to set you up the way he did and throwing you in what was akin to a fiery furnace. Thank God he didn't do that. But I think what was equally disturbing was the fact that when the fire was extinguished, Kane simply was not there. Aren't you concerned?
I hope that bastard's still burning.
Shane, please be careful out there. Okay?
The way I feel right now is I think it'd be best if you maybe just leave. You know, because this whole Kane thing, you know, I was the guy that motivated the guy, right? But I'm trying to motivate the guy to get him to the top. He took it to a whole different level. I don't think you or anybody else is safe while he's doing what he's doing. And hinging on what happened last week, hey man, I'm not the most sensitive sumbitch in the world. But just thinking about Shane McMahon,
Steve, I appreciate
maybe it'd be better if you just left.
I appreciate your concern, but if something's going down tonight, I say bring it on.
Excuse me.
What are you doing here?
right to be here, okay? That's what I'm doing here, but I came here tonight because I'm concerned, all right? Now, I'm concerned for your safety and your welfare. Because I've been told that something's gonna come down tonight. And all I wanna say is that I wanna clear the air with you and me. Maybe I haven't been the greatest dad in the world, but I've tried. So I just wanna know if, like, maybe you forgive me, if things are all right between you and me. I just need to know that. I need to know it now.
You're concerned about me? Everybody's concerned about me? Let's see how everybody's concerned about me out in the ring.
I think he's on his way to the ring, King. I think Shane is.
You know, people have been telling me all night to be careful, that they're afraid that something bad is gonna happen to me. Well, if something is bad is gonna happen to me, I say let it happen to me right here, right now.
So far, so good. Shane's waiting for it. He's got the guts, folks, I'll tell you. He is fearless. For better or for worse, he is fearless. This was not at least what I was expecting. Here's a stain on the underwear of life, Eric Bischoff.
Shane, just like everybody else, I heard you're gonna get yours tonight. And I just want you to know that I wouldn't miss it for the world.
What do these people think of
Bischoff? Eric, didn't you get enough at SummerSlam? And if you are the bad thing that's supposed to happen to me here tonight, then, excuse me for saying this, but that's a joke.
Oh, you think I'm a joke? Well, how about if I get into that ring and show you just how funny I can be?
Uh-oh, why don't you? Bischoff with a look of fright on his face. Well, like I said, this can't be, can it? The hell of a blackout here. I can't see a damn thing. I think, well, hey, look out, it's King! Oh my God, King! The 7-foot, 300 pounder. It's almost took Shane McMahon's head off.
Watch it!
Into the steel step.
Look at those bandages.
Those steel steps right in the cranium, right between the eyes of Shane McMahon. What the hell is King doing?
Where the hell did he come from?
Now what? King. He's handcuffed. A helpless Shane McMahon.
This does not look good, JR. Whoever tried to warn Shane that something bad was going to happen obviously knew something bad was going to happen. And this is.
Shane is defenseless. He got hit in the head with those steel steps, and now he's handcuffed.
This is bad. I don't know what that monster, that demented Kane has in mind.
Oh my God, come on. He's gonna press Shane. He's gonna run those. What the hell is Kane doing? Shane McMahon is trapped. Shane McMahon is trapped. And what is that? What is that? Why is Kane?
Water or what?
I think it's just a bottle. It's a bottle of water. Why was he pouring water over Shane? Wait a minute.
Look like jumper cables.
Oh my God. Oh my God, those are jumper cables. Look at this hideous freak of a human being. And that's a
He's not a human being. He's got a battery, JR. What the hell is Kane thinking? Shane is helpless. To Shane McMahon's testicles.
Don't you dare.
I've never seen anything like this.
Don't do this. Can we get something? We need some help out here now.
Kane taunting Shane McMahon.
This Kane is a lunatic.
Oh, my God. What the? This is hideous. This is cruel and inhuman. The pain's got to be excruciating. This is sick.
And here we go. There you go.
Rob Van Dam is back. Van Dam wearing Kane out with that steel chair. Sparkle the son of a bitch's brains. RVD taking the jumper cables off of Shane McMahon, who has been tortured. This is not over.
I thought I'd seen it all, JR, but that sick, demented Kane came up with something I had never seen before.
And look at that. Look at that badass Van Dam. Oh, that kicks Kane's ass. The Van Daminator eats some steel, Kane. You dirty, no good bastard. Rob Van Dam showing no fear. He's as gutty as anybody here, I promise you. Tear right to that hideous looking face of his.
Now what is Rob Van Dam trying to release? What kind of way? I don't know if he's going to be able to. Shane is handcuffed.
Kane is setting up. That monster is setting up.
Rob Van Dam's probably going to have to find some sort of key for those.
Shane McMahon has been punished and tortured. Kane is bleeding from the head. Kane is retreating for now. But it was obvious what this hideous monster wanted to do to Shane McMahon. But thank God, Rob Van Dam returned. And Kane, enjoying his handiwork, he's a sick, hideous human being that must be stopped.
Truly a monster.
No! Nobody knew Kane was going to come back. Nobody knew he was coming back. Kane, RVD was not supposed to be back this soon, but I promise you, next week, we'll settle this the old-fashioned way. It'll be Kane versus RVD inside of a steel cage.
WWE. Watch it. Force, the velocity.
Absolutely no regard on the part of Kane for any part of Rob Van Dam's body.
Well, Kane has no remorse. He has no conscience.
Not again.
Kane trying to break Rob Van Dam smack dab in half here tonight.
And he's doing a good job of it, JR. I knew this was going to be brutal.
Kane is systematically taking Rob Van Dam
look apart.
Crowd does not appreciate nor like that one bit. Kane, all the power
again.
The winner can either escape through the door or over the top of the cage, not through the cage. Now put RVD back in that ring, fix that cage this
to agree with Bischoff. That is the rule for that.
Well, Kane made a new door. He made a door with Rob Van Dam.
Look at the look at Kane's face. Look at the look on Kane's face.
Please don't put that kid back in there.
My God, Van Dam has gone through enough. How is Van Dam gonna survive Kane?
No.
We are back live. This steel cage match continues, and finally, Kane throwing Van Dam back into the ring. I think the cage has been repaired, but we had carnage during the commercial break.
It was unmerciful, JR, what went on during that commercial break. Take a look at this. Well, this is what happened before we went to break. This is how that cage got destroyed.
That is unmitigated. Off the cage, power and force of Kane and Van Dam again. He's using RVD's head as a battering ram into the steel cage.
I told you, he's sick, JR. Look, Kane could just literally walk out that cage door right now if he wanted to.
Kane doesn't want to escape. He wants Van Dam's career to burn in hell.
Wide open.
Kane is taunting him. He's taunting Van Dam.
Watch your head up.
Van Dam is out of. Van Dam is out of. Going on nothing but guts and adrenaline.
Like you said, all throughout that commercial break, Kane just relentlessly pounded poor Rob Van Dam. Check this out one more time with that steel door into Rob Van Dam's head. How much more can he take, JR?
I have no idea. I don't know very many people that would still be breathing and walking and trying to pull themselves up and trying to fight.
Listen to Kane. He's walking. He's like a cheerleader for Rob, saying, "You can do it, Rob Van Dam."
Oh, Kane's Van Dam. Kick him in the face. Kick him in the face, Rob. And get the hell out of there. Beat this monster. Beat this innocent. Son of a bitch, beating.
He's got one leg out. He's got one leg out.
Van Dam's halfway home.
He might do it, JR. He might get out of there.
Van Dam's halfway to the promised land, but to no avail, seemingly. And again, both men find themselves on the top row.
Oh, I think he's angry now, JR.
God, what a choke slam.
This could really get ugly
off
now.
Off the top, the choke slam off the top. And it is mercifully over.
Here is your winner, Kane.
Good God Almighty. What kind of human being is this Kane? He's a living, breathing, sadistic, unfeeling monster.
Yeah, I'm beginning to think he is not human at all, JR.
Kane is the most vile, hideous human being I've ever encountered. He is a walking, living hell on earth. Can he ever be stopped? The EMTs, the trainers, and medics are down here. Van Dam, my God, what an effort.
Perfect. Rob Van Dam, perfect. And look at Kane. He is so proud of himself. Oh, no.
It was hellfire and brimstone for Rob Van Dam tonight. But the question remains, is there a human being on the face of the earth that can hang with Kane?
Well, you know it's not RVD, or at least not tonight.
Not on this night. What a great effort by Rob Van Dam. What a great effort by Van Dam. You can't slight his heart and his passion, I can tell you that.
I'll tell you, before we went to that commercial break, I thought, even though he was almost destroyed, he was declared the winner. But then Eric Bischoff comes out and says, restart the match, and then this is the way it ended.
A choke slam by Kane on Van Dam from the top rope. And Rob Van Dam receiving. God almighty. Well, ready?
Oh.
First of all, now that Kane has finally eliminated Rob Van Dam, I think it's only fair that Kane get his hands on another miserable punk that I know Kane wants to eliminate.
Uh-oh.
So at Unforgiven, I'm gonna make a match. I'm going to make a match that's going to see Kane one-on-one against Shane McMahon.
Well, we'll hear from Shane live tonight from our WWE studios in Connecticut. Stanford, Shane, thanks for being with us. After what happened to you last week, the big question is here, how are you feeling tonight?
Well, it doesn't matter how I'm feeling, JR. All that matters is how Kane's going to be feeling in Unforgiven. Because like I've said in the past, as long as Kane is breathing in and out, I'm going to get even with that sick bastard.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Hold on just a second. Wait a minute. Get that camera on me.
What is this now?
Hey, sorry to interrupt, but this is my show, isn't it? This is my office. I have the power to do it. So let me, first of all, Shane, I'd like to know how you're feeling. You know, I mean, the whole world watches. You basically had those jumper cables hooked to your testicles. Everybody was wondering, oh my gosh, how could he survive that?
What's your point, Eric?
Well, my point, Shane, is you and I both know. You don't have any testicles, do you? And can you hear yourself? Can you hear the animosity in your voice? You know, now that you have agreed to this match with Kane, it becomes really clear to me that this just can't be a normal match. No way. Not a chance. And I don't want you to think that this has anything to do with what happened between you and I at SummerSlam, because, you know, there's no animosity here. Mm-hmm. Forgive and forget, right? But it occurs to me that the match with you and Kane at Unforgiven, it's going to be a very special match. It's going to be Shane McMahon versus Kane in a last man standing match. Because I always get the last laugh.
Screw you, Eric.
No, Shane, you're not listening. I just screwed you.
Bischoff, you're a no-good son of a bitch. Unforgiven. He's a jackass.
We're about to witness a contract signing for the last man standing match at Unforgiven between Shane McMahon and Kane. Now, in a last man standing match, anything goes. And the first man that can beat his opponent to the point where that man can no longer get to his feet before the end of a 10 count is declared the winner. And you know, we haven't had a last man standing match here at WWE in about 2 years. And due to the brutal nature of this match, both Shane McMahon and Kane are not only going to sign a contract here tonight, they are signing release forms so that no one in my administration can be held responsible for anything that happens at Unforgiven. And now, allow me to introduce the first opponent in this matchup, Kane!
Wow. What a monster. What a hideous, uncaring, unfeeling monster. I wouldn't want to even sit across a table from this sicko, much less get in the ring.
He threw a Bischoff off the stage. He set my big ass on fire. Tombstone Pile broke poor helpless Linda McMahon. He put a set of live jumper cables to the testicles of Shane McMahon, among other things.
Oh, look at him, he's smiling. He can't wait to sign this. I'm surprised he can write. That didn't take long. Ow.
And his opponent, and last man standing at Unforgiven, Shane McMahon.
Here we go. Here comes the money.
There ain't no doubt in my mind, after Shane McMahon hit Bischoff's ass at SummerSlam, that Bischoff is trying to screw Shane McMahon. And the way he's going to do it, look at Bischoff's smile. He's got Shane
signed, booked to be in a match with that monster in a last man standing match. Folks, there's no rules. There's no recourse. Once you're in, you're in. Only way to win is to beat your opponent senseless until that opponent can't make it back to his feet before a 10 count. It's that simple.
I just don't know what Shane's thinking. It's like you've said many times, he's got more guts than brains. That he's a true McMahon. Uh-oh.
Kane, I wanted to tell you this right to your face, that Eric Bischoff made this last man standing match because Eric thinks that this Sunday you're gonna annihilate me. And that may be true, Kane, but as sure as I'm standing here, let me tell you something. If I'm going down, you're going down with me. And actually, Eric, you did me a favor by making this a last man standing match. Because that means, Kane, that there are no rules. That means that anything goes. And Kane, look into my eyes when I tell you this. As long as I am breathing in and out, I assure you that I will be the last man standing.
The key words are, as long as you're breathing in and out. No, I don't. I just like the feel of this whole thing Sunday. It's just, this kid has got his whole life to live.
Yeah, and he's signing a release for it right now.
I know he is. He may be signing away more than that. More than we want to speculate on right here. This is just, I have an eerie feeling about this Sunday.
It's a done deal.
Wait a minute. Hold on here. This is supposed to be a contract signing, and that's it.
Shane is not exactly backing down, but I think he's saying, oh, look at this.
Kane now turning in Shane McMahon. Perhaps beating Kane to the punch here. Kane covering up. Shane McMahon hitting Kane with every low blow.
Every low blow.
And a third low blow. Monster. Oh, God.
Punt. Wow.
Shane McMahon got his testicles electrified with those jumper cables. And now Kane knows a little bit of how that feels. Shane McMahon taking it to the big red machine. Oh, yeah. Right in the spine of that steel chair.
That's electrifying.
And that's legal at last man standing. Anything goes. There are no rules. We'll get a little taste, a little sample of last man standing here tonight. Shane McMahon scrambling. What the hell is that? There's another announce table. What's that doing down there?
I have no idea.
Shane McMahon, those chair shots with that three low blows on Kane. Brought the monster at least to his knees.
Yeah, all those low blows, they are. Even Moxley's got to feel those.
Hell, oh, this kid, come on now. Shane, save it for Unforgiven. Shane McMahon, going up to the top here.
I got a feeling he's not going to save anything. He said if he's going down, Kane's going with him.
His own body on the line, and this is a small example of what I think we're going to see Sunday at Unforgiven. Shane McMahon is going to sacrifice his own body, his own heart and soul, King, if that's what it takes to win the match this Sunday. Last man standing at Unforgiven.
Well, you heard Shane tell Kane, look into his eyes, and as long as he's breathing in and out, that he was gonna take it to Kane, and you're right. He gave you just a little sample here of what Sunday's gonna be like.
Shane McMahon is standing now, but will he be standing in 6 days from the sold-out Giant Center in Hearst,
Jersey, Pennsylvania, at Unforgiven. Will he be standing this Sunday on pay-per-view?
Oh, my God. It came to set up.
It's up. Shane is, I think, realizing right now that it's going to take more than, maybe more than what Shane is capable of.
My God, Kane is up.
Who will be the last man standing on Sunday, King? Who will pay the ultimate price?